Today we're gonna make a fantastic 3D printable bank highlighting bundle groups, so let's get cracking. To make this a little more efficient, I'm gonna give you a template. If you type bit.ly/hlbank25, it'll take you right to the template project. Of course, it is set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad: give a reaction before you copy and tinker. So when you do use copy and tinker, you get an exact copy of my design. This is the mechanism we'll use in the back so that we can get the coins out of our bank. We're going to build today's bank with an awesome tool called the softbox. If you type soft in the search, it'll show up. We're simply going to bring this out, and then we're going to adjust it with the parameters. Note, if you ever drag the handles, it does break these. So I'm going to make this nice and small. I'm going to just go 7 centimeters for today's project. So if I do 70 by 70, and I'm going to make it 35 millimeters high. And then I want it to only have 2 millimeter walls. I like the outer radius of 6. That's a nice round shape. And then we're going to use this as a template. If we wanted to make a solid part, this is pretty slick, but I want to make a piece that inserts, and it's easier to do that with the sketch tool. So the first thing I'm going to do is line this right up with a grid line. Notice right now it is centered on that. And then I can move back to my other parts, and let's bring out the sketch tool. When we set this in, as you can see, it is totally lined up with the grid markers. So real quickly, if you're new to the sketch tool, don't forget the sketch features. This is an awesome tool that is put in here. They update it all the time. When new features are added, you can click through them, learn at your leisure. There are lots of cool tips of how to use the sketch tool most effectively. Once you've learned what you want, you can always just hit continue to sketch. It's easy to go back at any time. If you want to stick to my tutorials, of course, I'll have a link to the playlist up here. With those basics out of the way, let me show you how to draw this super slick. So the lines that matter are these corners right here. Check it out. I'm going to start in the center of our 2 millimeter wall, and I'm just going to click, and I'm going to go right to the other edge. Straight line. I'm going to press number 2 to do a bezier curve, and I just want to be in the middle. I'm going to click, hold, and twist with that straight line until it matches just the way I want, and then repeat the process all the way around. Staying in the middle, click, hold, once again, totally straight. That 566 becomes a check mark so that you know you're doing it right. If I twist these, it's wonky. If you keep them straight, it's perfect. Click and click, hold, twist, and bam! We have just made that exact same rectangle using the sketch tool. Now I see a little bump down here, so I'm going to double click and let's see what I did wrong. If I click on this handle, notice it's, I'm going to just bring it back one click, and that's what I needed to really get the smooth curve I want. Now Sketch has got some awesome new features. If you click down here, you can turn it to stroke. If you set it to center line, it all of a sudden completely matches what we had a moment ago. I'm going to hit finish sketch, click on our other one, and I'm going to delete it. Of course, I do want this one to be 35 millimeters high like I did a moment ago. And now let's simply double click so we can edit what we built. We're going to switch it to be the outer line. I'll show you why in just a moment. If we hit finish sketch, it ends up being a little larger than our other one, but check this out. If we do control D, so we've got two of these. Take the second one and make it real short. Let's say 1 millimeter. And if we go back into edit sketch, double click that 1 millimeter one and switch it from outside to inside and change the width so it fills all the way in. Finish sketch and you have just made the back and front of your bank. Let's grab these and move them to the side. Do control D and shift nudge to get it to the right so it's the front of the bank. And we need a rail for this to sit on once we're done printing. If you wanted to print it all together, you could. I'm going to do it separate so I can add some colorful words out here, and it prints a little faster. To do the rail, we simply do control D. I'm going to switch it to a different color so it's easier to see what I'm doing. I want my rail to be 4 millimeters high, so I'm just going to type 4 and press enter. And I'm going to do control shift up to move it up. Once I get it a little too high, I'm going to come back to even with control down arrow, and I'm going to go 2 millimeters below. Let's make the front of our safe 2 millimeters thick. And we just need to double click and change this from the current outside line, the center line. Notice now the blue edges stick out 1 millimeter and they stick out 1 millimeter this way. If you change this to 3, it gives you an extra 0.5 millimeter. When you hit finish sketch, you can now see how our bank has got a back, a bottom, and a ledge for the front to sit on. So we've done a lot of fun things with Sketch. Let me show you something cool with the bundle groups. This is a bundle group. It has got a hole inside. That's what that gray edge is. But that hole cannot affect the bundle group. What it does do, though, if you're watching right here, it affects the part underneath. So I'm going to select this, do shift click, do L for align, center, and center. Quick peek under. It's not grouped yet. If I do Control G to group, notice the hole did not cut the parts that were in the bundle group, but if you look underneath, it cut away the area for that part, so it'll actually function later. Now you could print this in place, but I'm choosing not to. I'm going to ungroup it, move the bundle over here, and I'm going to show you how to make a bundle by simply grabbing these two. Choose an L for align, making that one the boss, and center them. If I grab these two pieces, we're going to use the brand new bundle group, which is Control B, and we're going to do the same step to bring it in. Shift select, L for align, and we want it to be centered and centered. Now when we grab those two parts and do Control G, they union group, and you can see a little better how it was cut out, and then this will fit in afterwards just like it's supposed to. Now this is where you can decorate the front of your safe. I'm gonna just put, actually just sticking with the word Acme. Shift squeeze to get the size the way I want. Of course, set the thickness small as well. I'm gonna change the thickness to 1 millimeter. And let me know in the comments if anybody even gets the Wile E. Coyote reference. All right, I'm gonna quickly have some fun and I'm gonna put a fake knob on the front. You can get as fancy as you want with this, but let me show you how to do it. Of course, the first thing to do is bring out search and we're gonna type in snap and press enter. This is the snap fit connector. I cruised it on top of the shape. You'll notice if I click away, they are the same. I kept the default numbers. If you wanna make this a little smaller and a little less tall, you can try it. I just ran with it. So once I did that, I did Control D and I made it another one over here. I'm gonna delete this one now because you can obviously see it. And then I did D to drop it to the work plane and I switched it from the snap to the snap hole free spinning. I want the knob that I build to spin around this. You also need to make it into a hole so that it'll snap. I then went back to basic shapes and I grabbed a cone. And then I quickly checked this height, see how it's 10, and I fiddled with these numbers to find that I liked 16, 18, and 13 for what I was gonna call the knob on the safe. Of course, then I simply grabbed the two of them, did L for align, made this one the boss, chose center and center, with of course the other part sitting at the bottom. Now I wanted to have a cutout. This was so slick, I simply cruised out this shape right on the wall, and then I picked the measurement I wanted to cut in. This is what we call the living work plane. If you accidentally clicked and got rid of that, you can click on it and hit the letter E and it comes right back. Then I simply did Control down arrow to sink it in. I'm also going to go one arrow below so that it lines up and make sure it cuts all the way through. Grab those three shapes. Notice it only said two. So let's get a better angle and do this again. Select them and do Control G to group. Bang! We have just got a fake knob that we can snap on after it prints. We also need to add a hole for the coins. All I did for this was once again bring out the cube. I chose to make this size 35. I chose to make the height 8 millimeters. So you can see what I'm thinking. And when I shift select this edge, I chose L for align, made the box the boss, and I chose center, and I picked center on the height. Bang, just like that, our part is ready for printing. I'm gonna delete my extra one because I already had it. I will need to print all of these pieces. I don't need to print this one. So there are lots of ways to send this to a 3D printer. Today I'm going to send it all as one group, but I'm not grouping it. This hole will cut out all by itself. Tinkercad automatically notices when you export and takes holes that are on the last layer, and it cuts them in for you. I'm going to save it as an STL. In my 3D modeling folder, I'm going to call it bank and safe. And press enter. Then we can switch to Bamboo Studio, and I'm simply going to add the bank safe. All comes in at once. I want to print it with colors, and I may want to print it separate, so I'm going to show you how I would do that. So if I right click on this, I can choose split to objects. When I do this, you can see all these pieces right here. Note this one says it has non-manifold edges. I'm going to simply click on it and repair it quickly. I'm going to grab everything in here with Control A, and I want to set it to black. If I would have done this a step earlier, that would have saved me just a moment. Now I'm going to quickly zoom in, and I want to paint a couple parts of this. So I'm going to click on the object I want to paint. I'm going to switch to the paint tool. I'm going to make sure it has the fill button, and I want to detect edges. I'm going to paint the top of the button yellow, and then I'm going to back out. And I want to find the word Acme, and I'm going to paint it yellow as well. So I'm just zooming in and clicking on the top edge and painting that in a heartbeat. If you do want to paint all the edges, you can do it by hand like I am right here, but there's a faster way I'll show you in just a few minutes. All right, so with all my painting done, let's hit slice plate. And notice it is going to print in 2 hours. So I've already got that printing, and let me back up and walk you through something here. If we go back to our design, and I take these two pieces and do Control G, and then I keep the Acme separate, I'm going to export them separate. So if I do export, STL, and I'm going to just call this Acme, and then I'll click on this one and export it as an STL, and I'll just call it bank front. If we return to Bamboo Lab Studio, back to prepare, and we delete these, if we bring those in instead, so I've got the front and the words separate, if I bring them in, single object, multiple parts, check out how fast this is. Entire project, black, click on the Acme words, make them yellow, and it's a single click. So it actually makes it a little bit faster than the painting, although you do have to take the step of saving your project separately. No matter which way you do it, though, when you slice the plate, the time is pretty much the same. All right, so here we are. Fun little bank. Let me show you the back mechanism. That, of course, slides through and twists so it locks. You can snap this on. Of course, if you've got some sort of glue, that'll be good for fastening it. And then here is our fun little safe mechanism. Attaches easy peasy, and no matter how much you spin it, it doesn't open, but it's still kind of fun. You could have all kinds of other markings, whatever you wanted. And of course, it's a bank, so let's add some money. A fun project with lots of room for creativity and learning mechanisms. Pretty sweet for a classroom, and it even prints pretty quickly. How cool is that? So there you have it, a super fun bank. Of course, if you want a fancier bank, I've got a video up there that teaches you how to trace other objects and then use the same technique with the strokes so that you can make boxes that you close, turn into light boxes, or whatever you want. Friends, I do want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget, there are 3 different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. And with any level of support, you get early access to video. Also, a huge shout out to everybody that is part of my Patreon group. Love how that group is growing. We're way past 200 members. There is a fantastic message area. You really need to check it out. And of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.